Hey everybody, and welcome to my playthrough of Mass Effect Andromeda. This is a game I've been looking forward to for years, literally. I've been following the development, although once it actually got into closer to release date, I went into a media blackout, so this is actually going to be a mostly blind playthrough. And I say mostly because I have seen, like, you know, trailers, and I know the general premise of the game, and I did see a sheet that actually told me the names of the companions, but that's pretty much the extent of my spoilering for this. So I don't know what's going to happen when we press the start button and we start up. I know that there have been videos out there, but I exercised great willpower and my, like, as far as I'm concerned, great amount of willpower, and avoided watching those. So this is completely blind for me, as far as accepting those things I said. And I am so looking forward to this, and it's going to be awesome, I hope. And I hope I don't take too long in the CC, but I'm going to include that in the video as well, the character creator. Let's see what the options are there and everything too. But anyway, I am very excited. Let's get started with Mass Effect Andromeda. Okay. Status connecting. Oh, that's to my EA account. Yes, my EA account is SaraDaFan, if anyone wants to add me on Origin. Anyway, okay, so we've got quick start Sara Ryder, quick start Scott Ryder, or customize your character. Well, I'm not going to do a quick start. I did already go in and make sure subtitles are on and stuff, so yay. But yeah, so we'll just do a character, customized character. Man, this music is amazing. And I think I'm hearing a strain of that song, Lost Without You from Mass Effect 3 in it. And I love it. Your scanner allows you to view detailed information on nearby objects and lifeforms. Yes, thank you. Okay, right into it, so it's not included in the, there's no video beforehand, which is probably good. Alright, let's see here. Alright, so choose gender. Starts on import character data? No, upload character data. Import character data. If you set up an account on the Mass Effect Archives website, which I didn't, I should probably do that at some point, but whatever, this option allows you to import a Mass Effect Andromeda character you previously uploaded or use custom. Okay. Alright, anyway. Okay, so first of all, choose gender. Definitely female. Doesn't say anything. Yeah, male or female. Excuse me. Customize appearance. Let's start with that, I guess. Alright, so this is the default appearance. What's she look like? Now, I honestly like the default appearance, personally, but I want to see what the custom options are available and see what we've got. Let's see what we can go with. Now, I'm running the game on medium settings, just in case anyone cares. So I think the hair, this is what's going to look like for me, but whatever. Alright, okay. This is not a CC I'm used to. Alright, let's see the defaults first. Or presets, I mean. What is with that sound? Eh. Okay. In a computer, apparently. Alright. Can I zoom out a little bit? It's just, like, slightly it's just at that edge of slightly too close to their faces. For me? Okay. Fine. Alright, well, I'm liking some of the hair options I see. Ooh, she's pretty. Okay. I'm going for realistic anyway. All right. Well, that has character. She's kind of pretty. Let's see here. Okay, if I choose a head, does that, like, then pop me into the other CC options, or do I need to use this thing? Oh, nope, it doesn't. Okay, fine. Alright, custom appearance. I need to use this. Face. Or, well, back. Let me start. Dang it. Okay. This is gonna take a minute to get used to. Alright, so we've got this. This one. Where was the face shape I liked? This one. Actually, I like her nose and stuff. I like how her face works. Not the hair or the tattoo, really, but the face itself. This one's okay. Kind of like that one. No. Nah, I like this facial shape, so yeah. Alright, let's see here. Really? I can't use the... Really? Okay, that is annoying. Did I just not do it right? Okay, if I hit confirm on this, and then custom appearance... No, it does not. Reset appearance. Resetting will discard your customization choice. Yes. Alright, there we go. Now if I switch over... Okay, good. Alright. Double-clicking. Which was, I don't think, set anywhere on the screen. Of course, I could just be crazy. Alright, skin tone. Alright, it's at 0.64. Alright, higher number is darker. Let's go middle. I have no idea what this is going to look like in-game, but we will see. Alright, let's see. I actually think, let me first check hair, because I actually think I want to, this will be not a first for me, but it's rare for me to choose, or to make a blonde, but I think I'm going to see about making a blonde. Which would actually, let me switch to a skin tone that actually works with blonde. But isn't, like, lily pale, hopefully, which I don't know if I can do that. Let's see here. That's too dark. That kind of works. Okay. So yeah, let's see that one. Alright, now hairstyle. Her eyebrows are the wrong color too, but I don't know where to fix that. Let me see. Probably in face? Eyes? Nope. Brow? Brow height, brow depth. Hairstyle, hair color. Alright, so we could do this. Where is the eyebrow color? Alright, eyeliner, eyeshadow, that's all makeup. Scar and tattoo settings, is there not a brow color? Does that not get changed? Really? Well, I suppose, whatever. Alright. Huh, there's crazy hair. That's insane looking. That's kind of terrifying looking. Honestly, I don't like this hairstyle in general, but still. It's just kind of funny. Alright, I can have purple hair. They do have some nice browns, though. I haven't really made a brunette character in a while, either. I'll have to look at that, and brown actually looks pretty good. No, stop rotating. Alright, okay, let's see if I can decide on a hairstyle I like first, because the color is gonna be, applied differently across hairstyles anyway, so let's just start from this side. Start from here. Okay. Ooh, I actually like that. Oh, that's a ponytail. Of course I like that. I actually like that coloring. Honestly. Okay, cool. Alright, come on. One. Now was that? Okay. And that one's nice too. I like that one. Alright, this coloring is working so far. feel like there should be like a 1.5. Whatever. Alright, let's see here. It's very Jane Shepherd default, but I like that one too. Also nice. Wow, I'm running into a bunch of hairstyles I actually like. Although this looks a little messy now that I'm looking at it, but still. Ooh, that's pretty. Not for this character, but still, that it looks kind of cool too. Nah, too messy. It's cool, but too messy. Well, this is a very large ponytail. No, I don't think so. Oh, this is pretty. Looking at the first four, though, I really like those. Come on, go sideways. And now suddenly this looks a little better to me, even though this is the one we started with, but still no. Okay, that looks cool. Now the thing is, she's not military. Neither of the siblings are, I believe. So I don't necessarily have to go with like a military reg kind of cut. So I mean, this ponytail is cool. I do like this ponytail. I like the bangs on the ponytail and everything else. Like I said, I do like the default rider, and she has this hair. Or something close to this hair anyway. I didn't really look very closely, obviously. And I do like this this hair, but let's see here. Alright, let's choose. Okay, so we've got this one. Got the default ponytail. Got this one, which I actually do like. I like the hair or the hair floofiness on the top. This looks cool too. Alright, let's see what this... Okay, so the one... I currently have this selected, I think? Yeah. Yeah, that's the one I currently have selected. Could do this. Okay. Could be platinum blonde, but that's like way too... That's way too white. Too much white in my blonde. You know what? I think I am going to stick with the default ponytail. How's this look with this hair color? Yeah, this looks pretty good. Okay, let me just check the brunettes real quick just to... Yeah. I was using the mouse button to scroll and it actually changed it, so now I'm not sure which one I had. Crud. Although this one, this looks good. That's like too dark for this, really? Why did it go over there? Stop doing that. Alright, yeah, I think I like this one. Now, eye color. Can I zoom in and see the eye color a little better? No, I can't. Alright, fine then. Inner color, outer color. They're doing that again. Do we want to go for blue eyes? Blonde hair, blue-eyed. Could work. I'm moving the thing. I am clicking, and I'm not seeing anything. Oh, okay. That's what... Never mind. Whoa, this is weird. Alright, so the top point is what I want to go with. Ooh, that's actually a really pretty... I like that. The inner color is kind of a brown. Which gives it almost like a hazel thing. But no, I like exactly how the eyes look now. That is... Which color is this? Okay, 373 on the G. Yeah, and then if I have slightly more of a yellow kind of inner iris. There we go, and then make these. No. Stick with the darker blue, but not that dark. Crud. Pale blue? Okay. Alright, let's go with, let's mess with complexion if I can. I don't know if I can, actually. She just always gonna have those freckles? It could be a thing. It's gotta be something because, oh no wait, that would be tattoos. Never mind. Alright, brow height, I'm happy with that. Cheeks, I'm happy with that. This is why I find a preset face I like. I'm happy with her chin. Her eyes... Like, I'm not happy with her brow color, but I don't think I can change that. For some reason. I guess they thought blonde brows looked too weird? Or something? I don't know. Oh well. But mouth. Let's see here. Lip thickness. Lower that a bit. Not that much. Mouth height. Mouth depth. Mouth. Mouth width. Alright, so she could have a large mouth, could have a small mouth. Okay, nose. She's a prominent nose, but I like it. I like her. She looks good. Alright, let's go hairstyle, eyes. Okay, makeup. Let's see, lipstick. I don't know, the lipstick color actually works, I guess? Maybe. Wish I had like a. I wish I could like lock what the color was and then mess around with things and then like revert back to the color that I had locked. That would be nice, but yeah. Something. Yeah, okay, that's not too bright. That was, her lipstick color was bugging me because it was too much of a bright pink, but I like this. That looks good. Her blush is fine. Blush style. Opacity. Blush style. Oh, okay, that's why her blush is fine. She doesn't have any. Wow. What the hell? What is... what is that? What even is that? I don't even know. Streaks? Weird. Scales, and then like normal blush right there, which blush color. Let's see what we've got here for options. Well, every color in the rainbow apparently. Okay, come on. Thank you. Now, am I going to run into the same problem that Inquisition had where you can see the makeup in the character creator and it's like a certain level of intense and then not so much, and then it's like way too much in the actual game? Like, drop the makeup by a hair. Okay, that adds a touch of color to her cheeks. Let's see here. I wonder if there's an I don't even know if there's an in-game character editor, like the Black Emporium in Inquisition and Dragon Age 2. Like, I don't even know if there is one. Like, there wasn't one in the original trilogy of Mass Effect. So, but I am kind of nervous about this, because now I don't know whether I'm going to need to worry about that. But, I don't know, I think that makeup... I think that's okay. Let's see. 50. I can still see it if I'm focusing, so 50 will be fine. Alright, eyeshadow... No. But eyeliner style? Okay. What are the options here? Okay, no. That could be alright. What the hell? I don't even know. That's eyeliner, not eyeshadow? Weird. Okay. Alright, so that's eyeliner. This could actually... I actually like that. Let me see what the eyeliner color options are here. Okay, so not pink. I honestly don't know what would go with blue eyes. I suppose yellow, maybe? That's what they did with Leliana, anyway. No, I don't know. My makeup skills are not the best. Let's see here. This is a little intense. Let me see here. Eyeliner opacity. Nope. All right, and then eyeshadow. Eyeshadow style. Oh God, no. 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 Nope. Nope on that either. Nope. No. Okay, possibly. Alright, what's the eye color I have? 730, 173, 832. 830. Can you, like, type there? No? Dang it. Okay, 834, close enough. Alright. What was the other? Shoot. 730 and 173. 730. Good luck trying to get this. Jeez. Come on. 7. There we go. 730. 89,624. Yeah, that's not right. Alright, where is this? Okay, there's that on the color wheel. So this is not... Here we go. It's something close to that. Okay, so I could do... actually different colors if I wanted. Again, these are where my makeup skills are like, eh. Okay. Like this dark violet, I kind of like that. And the eyeshadow, let me see, there was this one? No. No, it wasn't. I'm thinking of eyeliner. Hold on. Eyeliner style. The next one was, no, not there. Alright, so I kind of like that. Maybe the... And then... Just a little bit. Okay, yeah. Alright. Like, I don't want to go too heavy on the makeup. But I kind of like, I like how the eyes are turning out. Let me see about skin color change. Skin tone. We make her two. That's two. Those are too pale. Now. A little darker. Now that it doesn't work with the hair. Alright. Nope. Okay. Alright, maybe I will take a slightly brighter color with the pink, with the lipstick. This is making her look too much like a doll or something, I don't know. Let's see here. Eyeshadow. Opacity. And then... that's at 40. This is also at 40. Wrong button. Hate all those, so no. Eyeliner style. And maybe, I don't know, mix it with a blue? That's weird. Hold on. Okay, so there's that. It's doing that. That's what I wanted it to do. Ooh, a powder blue kinda. That kinda works. Alright, yeah, a powder blue would work. And then. That's the eyeliner. And let me just decrease the opacity slightly on that, and not that much. Actually, leave that alone. Eyeshadow. Maybe, and then... Alright, so I could do that, or... I could try to take the... color from her inner eye. Does that look funny? That probably looks funny. All right, let me see here. Just increase the opacity of this just a little. Eyeliner style could be that too. Or just the under. No. Man, now I wish I'd watched some, like, makeup tutorials on YouTube or something. Alright. Let's see here. This. And then opacity on this. Down a bit. And then the eyeliner color. And then the opacity down on that. Okay, and then the lipstick color, let's go back to the slightly darker looking one. Okay, there we go. Alright, eyeshadow color, no, eyeliner color. Alright, do I want a darker? Okay, and then this. Okay, eyeshadow opacity isn't really sticking out at the moment. Maybe this is a horrible idea. Let me see here. Blues. Nah, I like the yellow. This may just be proving to certain people who are watching this, that my makeup sensibilities are awful, but I'm actually leaning toward this. Let's see here. Alright, so opacity is at 60. I actually kind of like this. Yeah, I think I'm going to stick with that. That is what I'm going to do. Alright, lipstick style. There are different lipstick styles. Alright, we're on number 6. Let me see here. Okay, basically. Whoop. Wrong button. Alright, whatever. Okay, so that's like Aria, I think. 7. Okay, I could have no lipstick as well, but I don't want no lipstick. Okay, that's the difference. Alright, I see it. If you do this, that'll give me an idea. Let's see here. Okay, so there's this. There's that. There's that, and that's gotta be complicated to set up in the morning, but okay. 4. That's interesting. It's like dark around the edges, but not as dark in the middle. 5 is just solid. 6 is basically 4. Whoa. There's a spiral thing. That's weird. Yeah, I'm not going to create a super crazy looking person in the first playthrough. So we will stick with... I'll stick with 5, actually, just to get solid lip coverage. Alright, and then... There we go. And a little gloss to her lips. There we go. Okay. Alright, scars and tattoos. Here we go. Let's see. Scar options. Not seeing it. Alright, scar intensity, just so I'm definitely going to see it when it shows up and I can, and it's visible for me. I'm not liking the blush. I'm gonna mess with that a second. Whoa, hello. Oh, there it is. Okay, so you can have a scar on your nose. Jeez. Scar on there. Oh, that's interesting. A scar along the side of your face, like it's only gonna be visible in certain angles. That's kinda cool. Someone hit you with a tire? I don't know what this is. Someone hit you with a tire. What is with this pattern? Isn't that the same pattern that was used for a blush earlier? Which, again, still don't know how that's... Someone hit you in the face with a tire? Hot tire. Burned you in the face with a tire. I don't know. Yep. Not good. This is like, technology went wrong. Someone got you with a scanner or something and it, like, burned your face. That's horrible. That is definitely something. That is your cat clawed you very badly. That is your cat clawed you very badly, but somehow didn't get your eye. Shrapnel or something. Alright. More shrapnel. Eh. Whoa. Wow. That looked like that hurt. These look like newly bloody wounds with this intensity, but yeah. You can't change color on them either. Interesting. A very faded scar. Oh, that actually looks kind of cool. It also looks kind of like a birthmark. Which I could do, I suppose, but... Eh. No. No. Wow. They were like, what's the gnarliest looking scars we can come up with? I might give the brother a scar. Yes, I am going to CC, do the CC for the brother too, because apparently you can affect both of them. Ooh, this actually, I do have a thing for liking these kind of like little eye scars and stuff. Those can be very cool. No. It's alright, but no. Okay, nah, I don't think I'm gonna give her a scar. Let's see, tattoo designs. Tattoo styles. Oh, hello. Okay, so you can change color, but... Alright, that's tattoo 1, 2. That's a crazy tattoo. That is interesting. What's this one look like? Oh, that is... That's actually cool looking, I like that. Nope. How did I end up in... No, I want tattoos, thank you. Where'd that one... Oh, okay, the other side. Dang it. No, I don't want scars. No scar. Stop switching over to to scars from tattoos. I do this and it goes... What the heck? Alright, that's annoying. Okay, come on. Let me see, what's that tattoo? Where's this one? It did it again. Oh, okay, it's up on the... That tattoo is up under her hairline. You can't see it on this hair anyway. Alright, that actually looks... That looks pretty cool. It looks like a cartography thing on your head. That's pretty cool too. That looks... That looks like you have a, I get it. You have, boom mic, like, next to your face. Okay, that's what that looks like to me. Alright, cool. Other side. Okay, so there's this one that they've shown in one of the presets. That does look neat. Other side of it, and then goes around your neck. I don't think I'm gonna give her a tattoo either. Whoa, definitely not gonna give her that one. Okay. They include that in like every Bioware game. It's gotta be an in-joke or something. That's been in there since Origins. Alright, well, okay. So, am I happy with this? Oh, right, I wanted to check the blush on her. Now, let's see if I can remember what she looks like for when I create the brother, but yeah. Alright, so slightly on the... Slightly going more pink. There we go. Alright. Back. Confirm. Okay, and this is my female rider. Now, if I choose the gender of your character. If I go from male to female, I swear to God, if I go from go to male and back to female and it doesn't change, and it goes back to like this thing. Okay, God. All right. I thought it was going to go back to default. All right, so choose gender. Choose what her brother is going to look like basically. So I guess you can't have the... Alright, it looks like you can't have the default... Well, you can have a default Scott. And a... Oh my god. Custom appearance, yes. Okay, confirm. Alright. Okay, that's the confirm... Okay, good. I was about to freak out. Anyway, so yeah. So you can have a default... It doesn't look like you can have one of the default siblings and then a non-default sibling. Although, maybe? Nope, you can't. Okay, so I'd have to customize. I have to customize the guy, too. Alright, well, I'm going to try to get a little faster with this. Alright, let's see what we've got here. Whoop. No. Okay. Eh. Maybe. It's got about the same nose that she did. Let's see. No. Okay, well, there's a lot of options here, and I think I'm gonna take a little while figuring this out, and I don't want this episode to be 2 hours long, so I will be back when I am near done tweaking it, and I'll join you guys then. Okay, so I've made some changes to one of the presets, as you can see. I think I'm pretty happy with him now. I've just got to... I kind of like this hairstyle, but I'm going to show off the male hairstyles just to see, just to show you guys. But yeah, there's this one, there's that one, which is eh. Nope. this one's okay, I guess. Then there's this one, which is the one I think I'm going to go with, because I really like that one. Well, it's one of the... I don't like nearly as many of the male hairstyles as I do the female ones. They did a really good job with the female hairstyles this time, as far as I'm concerned. But the male... Eh. Okay. I mean, I'm sure it'll work with some characters, but none of them are really working with what I picture as my Scott Ryder hair, so... Except for that one. Alright, and then there's this one. Another high and tight. Kind of... Well, I don't know if that's what it is, but it's got the shape sides. And that, which doesn't really work for him at all. And shaped. Okay, so not doing that. I think I'm gonna go with this. And while I was messing around with things, I found out there was a customized twin button down here, so I don't need to use this button here. Okay, so we've got him, and we've got her. Now let me just make sure. I did tweak her a little bit too, changed her coloration just slightly. Now her skin tone, just to make sure I've got that right, is 15. I moved her mouth around a little too, but yeah, 15, and then his is also 15. Now I wanted a bit of color to his lips, so it's not really lipstick in my opinion, but I did want like something other than it was really pale otherwise. Not sure. There we go. That's uniform at least. Nah. Alright, what is that that's covering the whole... Okay. But yeah, as far as I'm concerned, this is just flesh tone, or at least as close as I can get to flesh tone without it, like... But making sure that it also stands out. So... Yeah, solid color. Okay. I mean, that's basically his color, the color that he has anyway. The color that he has anyway without anything. But it's just a little more... It's just a little more pronounced doing this way, which is what I like. Alright. Okay. So I think that this... I really wish I could change those eyebrows, but other than that, I think this is my Scott Ryder. So this is Scott, and then I'm gonna stick here with the name. It says choose your first name. Choose a first name for your character. And I can choose a different name, but the thing is I heard that Sara, if you stick with it, stick with the default, is actually said in the game, like by other characters when they're talking to you and not just calling you Ryder. They'll actually use the first name Sara, so I think I'm going to stick with that. Plus I do like the name Sara, so I was considering sticking with it before. Alright, and then the last thing, I don't think I chose... No, I did not. Okay. Okay. Alright, we've got technical details, security. Okay, so we've got training that we can select. During your Alliance military service, you focused on learning everything you could about weapons and tactics. And that means you start off with concussive shot, which is cool. And turbocharge grants a massive short-term boost to weapon fire rate and thermal clip efficiency. Combat fitness grants increased durability and the option to carry more weapons into battle. All right. We've got biotic. You were effective. Whoop. Didn't mean to do that. Okay. You were effectively designated biotic during your Alliance military tenure, assisting your cohorts with your ability to control mass effect fields. Is that like designated driver? Designated biotic? I like it. Starting power, throw. Use your biotic powers to hurl an opponent through the air. Maybe. Whoop. Dang it. Okay. I'll just use the arrow keys, how about that? Alright, technician. As a technician in the Systems Alliance military, you learn to operate drones and hack enemy systems. Alright, and that starts off with overload, which is always useful. Unleash an electrostatic discharge that deals high damage to shields and synthetic enemies. Can chain multiple targets. Nice. Got leader. You were a team player and a natural leader in the Alliance military, working closely with your cohorts for their safety and the safety of others. Energy drain is the first ability there, and it's drain your target shield to replenish your own, especially effective against synthetic enemies. And then there's scrapper, which is when a fight broke out, you were always the first soldier in the thick of it. Mostly according to Alliance military protocol, and occasionally not. Alright. Starting power, charge. Launch yourself like a comet at opponents and regain a portion of your shields on impact. So basically Vanguard. That is cool. Thinking about that. An operative. In the Alliance military, you studied covert operations and the tech used by special forces. Knowledge you rarely found a use for until the Andromeda Initiative. Starting power is tactical cloak. Employ light bending technology to become invisible for a short duration. Gain a large damage bonus when you break cloak to attack. Ooh, now this is nice. I did play an infiltrator, as my Cannon Shepherd is an infiltrator. So I am tempted toward this, but I kind of want to do something new too, so... I am torn between technician and operative. Technician, unlocked skills. Invasion, hack into your opponent's armor and weapons, infecting them with a computer virus to weaken their defenses, and even spread to nearby foes. Interesting. And team support. Develop specialized technology to bolster the survivability of your entire squad, which is very useful, I think. Let's see. So, tactical cloak, unlocked skills, combat fitness, and tactical cloak. Okay. Grants increase, combat fitness grants increased durability and the option to carry more weapons into battle. You know what? I've had the desire to play an engineer, and I've just never really liked playing an engineer in the original trilogy. But this actually seems kind of cool. And so I think I'm going to go with technician this time. So Sara is a technician, and her name is Sara, got that. Customize history. Okay, well my shepherd was a female. Okay, that looks like it's the only choice you can make. Alright, so shepherd was a female. Upload character data. Check this option to upload your character to the Mass Effect Archives website, where you can re-import it in the future or share with friends. Cool. Import character data. If you set up an account on the Mass Effect Archives website, this option allows you to import a Mass Effect Andromeda character you've previously uploaded or use custom appearances that others have shared online. Okay, so I can use other people's riders, basically. That's kind of cool. But yeah, I don't need to do that. So, okay, I guess it looks like I'm done. I'm just checking them one more time. It's got the same high cheekbones. Roughly the same mouth shape, definitely the same eye shape, and the same coloration, I guess? Hold on. Is he just a little too pale? Let me just knock that up by slightly. Alright, now that... And, well, I don't need to go all the way up to that. Like, I know that it says the same number, but this looks more like... 20 on him looks more like 15 on her, in my opinion. Let me see here. So sideways, we've got this and that. Okay. Yeah. Alright, I think I'm ready. So, what do I do? Confirm and start a new game. Alright, so female custom appearance, technician, Sara Ryder, twin custom appearance, and history, female shepherd. Oh, okay. Okay, so we have difficulty level. Let's see here. This difficulty level is intended for players who are more interested in story than combat. Challenge level is very low. I don't think so. Casual level. Challenge level is somewhat reduced, as in from normal, I suppose. Alright, players inexperienced with shooters. We've got normal, which is the difficulty intended for players with experience in playing shooters and RPGs. Baseline combat experience. Now, I remember in the original trilogy, I tended to be able to play on hardcore or insanity, depending, because I liked the level of challenge on those, and once I got used to them, I didn't die as easily. But I have a feeling, because they did get complaints about the combat experience being a little too easy or something, maybe they've learned from that, but maybe they haven't. I don't know, so I am torn here. This difficulty level, hardcore, is intended for players looking for a challenge. Advanced gameplay skills required. Insanity, this difficulty level is intended for players seeking the ultimate challenge. Yeah, I'm not gonna do insanity on my first run. That would be insane. But hardcore... Well, I can always bump the difficulty down, so I will start on hardcore and see where that takes me. Alright, would you like to start the game? Okay, I guess that's it. Alright, so I'm going to end this specific video here, and then next video we will start up and we will get right into the game. See you then.